And welcome back to Strawberry Lemon. My name is Melody, and today I have a vlog for you. So I am going to be vlogging reading The Lightning Thief by Rick Riordan for the first time ever, and I'm so excited. Okay, so for those of you who don't know, this book is about Percy, and he is a half-blood, so his dad is a god and his mom is a mortal. So he kind of has special powers and monsters kind of want to kill him, but he doesn't know that until he goes to the half-blood camp and he goes on a whole quest to get Zeus's lightning bolt back because they think he stole it, which implicates his dad and everybody. He's trying to stop a war by returning the lightning bolt. So he has to go on a quest and meets a bunch of monsters and everything. But yeah, so this is going to be a spoiler-filled vlog. Spoilers! Spoilers! So if you have not read this book and you're planning on reading this book, please click away. You can leave a comment down below and be like, I was here for your video and I appreciate it so much, but I don't want to spoil you, so please click away. But yeah, I feel like a lot of people have read this book already and I haven't. I watched the movie a long time ago because we had to watch it in class, and this book is so much better than the movie. And yeah, if you're prepared to watch me just go over all my reactions, just keep watching. I'm probably gonna separate this video into sections, so some of the monsters might be in a certain section. So if you have a certain part of the book that you really liked and want to see my reaction to it, just look in the comments down below. And yeah, let's get into it with some vlog footage. Bye! About 100 pages into the book already, and so much has happened, and let's just get right into it. So the really beginning of the book, it starts like this. Look, I didn't want to be a half-blood. If you're reading this because you think you might be one, my advice is close this book right now. And oh my gosh, when I read that, I was like, is Percy Jackson attacking me right now? Because I feel like everybody kind of goes through that stage of, oh my gosh, is something magical gonna happen to me in the future when I turn 16 or 18? Maybe I'll meet a werewolf or a vampire or a witch or a dragon or goblins or fairies or something. I'm 20 now, so I'm kind of over the phase of thinking something magical will happen to me, but in my heart, I still hope something will happen one day. But yeah, I was like, Percy Jackson, is he attacking me? Because it would be kind of cool to be a half-blood. It seems fun and dangerous at the same time, but fun. And yeah, so far I am loving Percy Jackson as a narrator. He's really funny, and I did not know that he was only 12 years old. That's so young, but this is, I think, a middle grade, so that makes sense. But I was like, I would not be able to do what he's gonna do at 12 years old. No way. And yeah, so we've met some important people in Percy Jackson's life already. We've met his mom and his best friend Grover, and they are both so cool. So starting with his mom, she has spunk. She has character. She knows about gods and goddesses and monsters and everything. And oh my gosh, I was like, why is Percy's mom still with Percy's stepfather? Because Percy's stepfather, he's just not it. I feel like she's probably with him to protect Percy or something like that. But One thing that I thought really showed her personality, that she's not just a pushover, is the whole blue foods thing. So if you don't remember, the whole blue foods thing is that Percy's stepfather said that blue foods don't exist. And Percy's mom is like, excuse me, what? So she goes out of her way to bake blue foods, to buy blue candy, to buy blue colored drinks, to prove him wrong. And I'm like, yes. Personality. And then Grover, oh my gosh, Grover, I feel for Grover. He is trying to follow his dreams, but he's failing. And when Percy called Grover a donkey and Grover got all upset and he's like, I'm not a donkey, I'm a goat, I'm like, I'm dead. And then what else has happened so far? Oh, we've met some of like the mythical beings kind of thing. So Percy's math teacher is a fairy and she was like disguised as a human and almost killed Percy. But Percy's teacher, who is actually a centaur, threw Percy a pen that turned into a sword. A pen that turns into a sword. Do I even need to explain how cool that is? That is so cool. And then we've met the three fates who was cutting the yarn. And I was like, no, cutting the yarn is a very, very bad sign. Very, 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 very bad sign. And we've also met the Minotaur. And oh my gosh, I can't believe Percy killed the Minotaur. And the Minotaur might have killed Percy's mom, which is like, what? We're only 100 pages in the book and a person might have died already, but actually she turned into a ray of light. So she might not be dead. Or if she is dead, her spirit is in the underworld. And I'm pretty sure in the movie, Percy goes to the underworld, I think. I'm not sure, but yes. So I was like, that fight scene, the running away from the Minotaur, and then Percy like dragging Grover over the property line to safety and everything. It was just so good. And then now finally he's at camp, which camp sounds awesome. One of my favorite things about the camp is the rock climbing wall. Rock climbing walls and like life is just cool. And then they have it like a whole nother level. Their rock climbing wall is trying to kill you. There's lava, it like closes in on each other, it rumbles. It is, you gotta climb as fast as you can. And that just sounds deadly but fun. That's like the whole theme of this book, deadly but fun. And we've also met Clarice, who is the daughter of Aries and tries to pick on Percy, but that did not work out for her because Percy just like sprayed a bunch of toilet water on her, which is really, really disgusting, but so funny to read. And then we've also met Luke. And I think Luke is a traitor. I know from the movie that there is a traitor, but I do not remember who. And I'm pretty sure it's Luke because he seems to be like that golden boy that's perfect, but he is the son of Hermes. And Hermes, one of the things Hermes is known for is for stealing. And somebody stole Zeus's lightning bolt. And Luke was one of the students that went to Mount Olympus, so he had the chance to steal the lightning bolt. And also, there was one scene in the book where Luke was talking about the gods and he sounded bitter. I remember that. So I was like, I think Luke is the traitor. Oh, and one last thing is I am so curious to know what happened between Percy's mom and Poseidon, because I'm pretty sure Poseidon is Percy's dad and Poseidon doesn't have any other children besides Percy, I'm pretty sure. So does that mean that Poseidon loved Percy's mom? Because that would be so awesome. I would totally ship that. That would be so like cute and just aww, like, yeah. And I think that's all I have to talk about for now. I'll see you in the next update. Bye. I'm a dirty trove like I'm she a fool. No intention, now you're loose, no manner is wrong. Go and pick the favorite fool, get a shot of two. Hold the bottle, go food, oh, I make a sound too. I'm regularly up for y'all. None of it matter at the end of all. I'm finna be seeing the cause. Jumping to go to the mental state. I don't fuck with none. Y'all say it's a phase. Say it's a way of playing. How to seek and only to gravitate towards the love and up of vanity. I sail the night alone till I see the bottom level. Yeah, send my heart a tour. Finna let them know the medicine. Yeah, from the night I've shown and I keep it going. Says no, send my chemical. Sunday's painted eyes on a moon. Camouflage and a fake disguise. I don't sneeze or cough a lot during this because my allergies have been so bad today, but I have about a third of the lightning thief left and it's update time. Okay, so first I want to talk about Annabeth because I don't think I've talked about Annabeth yet, but she's just so cool. I feel like I say that about everyone in this book because everyone's just so cool, but Annabeth is the daughter of Athena and she has a dream of being an archetype and creating kind of like a big monument or something in honor of the gods and everything. And I was like, that's so cool. I actually thought about getting into architecture before college, but that didn't happen, but yes. And then one of the things that I really like about her is that she's afraid of spiders, which I was like, yes, somebody who's afraid of spiders, because I'm afraid of spiders and bugs in general. And yeah, she always seems so kind of confident in herself and her abilities. So I was like, yay, she has a fear, which makes her more human, I guess. And then she also has a crush on Luke. And I'm like, Annabeth, what are you doing? Because I swear that her and Percy Jackson are supposed to be a couple. I'm pretty sure that's what happened. But if Luke is a traitor, it won't matter anyways. Okay, now on to some of the monsters we've met. So we've met Medusa, which is so freaking cool. Medusa is kind of like the first monster you learn about in class and everything like that, and I'm pretty sure their encounter was so different from what was in the movie and so much better. But they met Medusa at like a warehouse kind of thing called Auntie M, and it was just, they killed her, chopped off her head, and he sent it to Olympus. I was like, damn, Percy, you trying to get on the god bad side. But I'm pretty sure he's already on people's bad sides anyways, so whatever. And we've also met the Chimera and Echidna, and damn, that duo. I was like, Percy is gonna die. What is gonna happen? How is he gonna get out of this? And he jumped out of the freaking floor down like thousands of feet into the water, and what? He did not die. He can heal himself in water. He can, everything he touches turns dry. Like, he stays dry underwater, which is so cool. Just so cool. And then he got a message underwater to not trust the gifts. So I'm thinking it's either the gifts he got from Ares or the gift he got from Luke, which was the flying shoes. So Ares with the backpack or Luke with the flying shoes. I don't know. I'm still thinking Luke, but maybe it's both of them. Maybe they like teamed up or something. And yeah, speaking of Ares, when he walked in, I was like, damn, who is this? He sounds like trouble. Oh, I don't know. Ares is just interesting, I guess. He seems really cool, gives you the bad boy vibes, but can probably also be a huge jerk. And yeah. And then onto Grover. I feel so bad for him because he was leading Thalia and Luke and Annabeth to camp, and his job was Thalia because Thalia is the daughter of Zeus, and Thalia ended up sacrificing herself so everyone else could get to camp, and she got turned into a tree, and Grover was blamed for that. And I was like, oh, Grover. And then his dream of trying to find the god Pan is just because his whole family has done it and none of them has returned, and he wants to do it. I'm like, ah, Grover, I really hope you like can achieve your dream. Also, Grover can talk to animals. He randomly found a pink poodle and he can talk to animals apparently, and he was like, Percy, say hi to the poodle. And Percy's like, nah, bro. And the Annabeth's like, I say hi to the poodle, you say hi to the poodle. I was like, okay. And then Percy's dream of somebody talking to him with the dark pit, I'm pretty sure it's Kronos trying to rise back and take back power from the Olympians. And it's just, so much is happening. I'm so excited to read the rest of the series. And I think that's all. Oh no, I have one more thing to say. It was when, oh my gosh, when Percy met the echidna, and she's like, I am the great, all-powerful mother of monsters, the echidna. And then Percy's like, isn't echidna the name of an anteater? And she's like, oh my gosh, I hate Australia for naming them after me. What the hell? And blah, blah, blah. And I was like, that's just, I cannot. And yeah, I think that is all I had for this update. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Call it a game, know that it's obvious. I ain't got nothing to say. Negative damagas. Loving the fake impressions, I get it daily. Frankly, I'm on the road to changing the same thing over and over again till I throw up with a grown up. Ego is all you got, funny your tells a plot. Cover the smells you got, beat up every raise and follow whatever you say you thought. So yeah, a shout out to failure's never an option. Failure's never an option. Failure's never an option.
Painted eyes on it, camouflage on it.
It's time for our last update, and it's raining really, really hard right now. There's some hail, there's thunder, there's lightning. So I was like, this is a perfect time to film the last update for the lightning thief because I finished. Hopefully the rain sounds don't sound annoying. I thought it would be like a cool setting and the thunder. But yes, okay, so the lightning thief. So another monster that we've met, well, not was there a monster? Another thing, another encounter that Percy Jackson and like his crew and Grover and Annabeth met was when they got to the Lotus Casino. And when I heard Lotus Casino, all I could think about was the Avatar and Uncle Iroh and his like white lotus chip or whatever it was called. I was like, oh my gosh, okay, this storm is so bad. Anyways, when they got there, I was like, this casino is the dream. There is water slides, there's arcade games, you get a credit card to get anything you want, play all the games you want. And yeah, I was like, how are they gonna get out of this? And then they left, and then they got to the mattress place. Okay, so you might be asking, wait, did she just change her shirt? Why, yes I did. And you know why? Because I am dumb. I am so dumb. I accidentally permanently deleted my own footage from my phone because my phone never has enough space, so I always have to go back and delete all of my videos, my old videos. And I was filming stuff for Becca's Bookathon, and then I deleted my footage in the storm for this video. So I'm really sad because it was a huge storm. So right now it's kind of raining. I don't know if y'all can hear it, but yeah, it's raining now. It's not a huge storm like the one from before, but I'll take what I can get. I still wanted to keep the rainy like mood kind of thing because it's called the lightning thief. Will there be lightning or thunder right now? Probably not, but it's fine. It's okay. I'll deal. And yeah, I think I left off on the mattress person that he legit puts people on his mattresses and they have to be exactly 6 feet. And if they're not 6 feet, he has a stretching machine kind of thing that just stretches you out. And I'm like, I'm short, but I would never, like, I'm fine with being short, okay? It's all good. It's fine. But stretching yourself out to be taller, well, he's forcing them, but that's, yeah. And then he chops people off if they're too tall. And I was like, Percy tricked him into getting on his own mattress, and then he chopped off his head, and I'm like, oop, that just happened. And yeah, so after that, they finally get to Charon, I think that's how you say his name. And Percy really knows how to talk to people because he can just distract everyone. Charon is like, oh my gosh, yeah, do you know how boring this job is? And I haven't gotten a pay raise in like 4,000 years. This is ridiculous. Blah, blah, blah. And Percy, he's like the master of distraction. And then, yeah, they finally get down to the underworld and the river Styx is like all dirty and polluted. And I'm like, this book is incorporating a bit of everything and it's just so cool. And then we see Cerberus and I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so sad. It's a, he's just like a big, not fluffy, he looks scary, but he's like a teddy bear on the inside. In his heart, he just wants a friend. He just wants someone to play with him. And when the red ball got destroyed and Annabeth had to leave him because she was distracting him, and he just kept whimpering trying to find her because she's like his new friend, I'm like, this is so sad. I really hope that Cerberus pops up again in other books because I just need more of him. My heart's soft for him. And then the flying shoes. I knew it. I knew that Luke was a traitor. The flying shoes that try to drag him into like the pits of Tartarus, and I knew it. And then, oh my gosh, Hades. When Hades, he's like, do you think I want to start a war? Have you seen the overpopulation in the underworld? Like, I have a lot of money, but it takes so much money to keep up all of these souls. And I'm like, yes, Hades. I feel like Hades, he's depicted as the evil person or whatever. And I'm like, why y'all always gotta do that to Hades? I was like, yes. He seems cool. And he's the first one that's looked godlike, which is really cool. And oh my gosh, when Percy blurted out, Charon wants a pay raise. And Hades is like, don't you get me started on him. I'm like, yes, Hades. I really like him. And then, oh my gosh, it was so sad when Percy had to leave his mother behind. I did not remember that from the movie because I watched it so long ago. But that was so sad. I teared up. And then when they got back up, the battle between Ares and Percy was epic. And then all the humans thought that they were holding guns and that's how Percy got his name cleared. But that battle, and he actually stabbed Ares, and they have gold blood. Percy finally goes to Olympus. He meets his dad and he meets Zeus, and Zeus is like, don't you ever dare go in my domain on planes ever again. I'm like, okay, is that really what you're thinking about right now when your father is trying to, you know, come back from the pits of Tartarus and kill you all and take over the world again? Is that really what's important? And he just brushes off the subject. He's like, don't talk about it. If I don't think about it or hear about it, it's not happening. That's how what Zeus seems to be. And Poseidon, oh, when Poseidon and Percy were talking, it was really real, I feel like. It wasn't rainbows and unicorns. Also, everybody just forgot about Luke. I was like, excuse me? Did you forget about the shoes? What? It just passed everyone's mind. I was all, when are you gonna take down Luke? Expose him, take him down and capture him, or, you know, I don't know, whatever you do to people that are traitors. But what? Everyone just forgot about Luke and how the shoes was trying to drag him to Tartarus. And I just couldn't. And then when Percy followed him into the woods. No, why? And yeah, so the prophecy came true. And Percy's mom, I'm so happy that Percy's mom's back and turned Percy's dad into stone. Her letter was so funny. And yeah, I'm super excited to see what the next book will have. I feel like this book kind of came a full circle. Near the beginning, it has Annabeth healing Percy. And then in the end, it's Annabeth healing Percy again. And he's probably gonna run into monsters since he's going back home. Oh, also Dionysus is funny. I don't know. I feel like he might be a little underrated. People probably don't talk about him too much because at least in the first book, he's not in the book a lot. But every time he's there, he's so funny. And Yeah.
Oh my gosh, this end of the vlog is like super chaotic and I'm sorry, but I totally forgot to mention that I ended up giving this book 5 out of 5 stars. This book is just, it was so good. The characters were good. I loved all the characters. Cerberus stole my heart. It's just, they were just, it was just a good book. The storyline, the Greek mythology, and it's just there's no words. Oh, I forgot to mention also, I am a mess, but this is going to be a series. I don't think the other vlogs for this series would be as long, but we'll see. And yeah, that is it from editor me. Back to old me.
Oh, and one thing I really wanted to mention was that I noticed throughout the book that ADHD and dyslexia was mentioned a lot. So I was really curious why that was. And I actually found this really cool interview that I'll link down below. And it's actually that Rick Riordan's son was diagnosed with ADHD and dyslexia in the second grade. And the only thing that really interested his son in school was the myth section of class. So Rick Riordan kind of told his son bedtime stories of Greek myths, and when he finally ran out of stories to tell, he made up Percy Jackson, which I think is so cool. And it says that this is kind of his way of telling his son that learning differences don't mean there's anything wrong with you. In fact, it is a mark of being very special indeed. And I don't know, I thought that is really important and really adds to the story. And it also says it can be really empowering for kids to know that they are seen and understood. They may behave or process information differently in a classroom setting, but that doesn't mean they are flawed. Yeah. Diversity and inclusivity in books and everything in life is just so important. And I love the whole inspiration behind the story and everything. And I just, it just really adds to the book, and I feel like this is a series I'm gonna read over and over again, even though I'm only on the first book. I kind of rambled a lot in this vlog, so hopefully y'all still enjoyed it, but I had fun making it, so that's all that really matters, right? And yeah, I think that's all I had to say. I will see you next week then. Bye!